Good morning, everyone, and thank you. My name is Jennifer Orme-Zavaleta, and I'm the Principal Deputy Assistant Administrator for EPA's Office of Research and Development, along with being the Acting EPA Science Advisor. And I'd like to thank you all for tuning in to today's live event to hear about an exciting and innovative opportunity. Nitrogen and phosphorus fertilizers facilitate the growth of crops, including corn, at yields that provide sustained global food production. However, fertilizers applied without the consideration of the appropriate rate, timing, source, and method can impact the environment and human health. Today, EPA and USDA, in partnership with our collaborators, are announcing an exciting opportunity to address the issue of excess nutrients while also maintaining or promoting crop yields to support our national agricultural needs. To kick off this announcement, I am honored to introduce EPA's Administrator, Andrew Wheeler.
Thank you, Jennifer, and thank you all for joining us today. Many of you are probably aware that this year marks the 50th anniversary of the establishment of the Environmental Protection Agency. So while we gather here today to mark the launch of the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenges, I'd like to note how this marks a milestone of achievement for EPA. Throughout EPA's existence, there's probably been no better example of America's leadership in environmental protection than the nation's success and the agriculture sector. Each year's harvest is a testament to last year's commitment to stewardship and sustainability. And no other country matches the productivity of the American farmer. But as any farmer knows well, continued success means continually looking toward the future and seeking ways to improve techniques and increase efficiency. So that's what the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenges are all about: sparking innovation that will improve the ways we use fertilizer. If successful, this challenge will result in lower cost to farmers and consumers, while at the same time lowering the negative impacts excess nitrogen and phosphorus have on our environment. EPA is therefore proud to announce the launch of the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenges in partnership with the U.S. Department of Agriculture. I'm very pleased to see Secretary Sunny Perdue at USDA. Sunny and I have worked together on a number of projects, and I'm very proud to work with him closely on this project as well. We're also working in coordination with some great organizations, including the Fertilizer Institute, the International Fertilizer Development Center, the National Corn Growers Association, and the Nature Conservancy. This competition will advance U.S. agriculture by increasing the efficiency of nutrient-based fertilizers in ways that lower their impacts on the environment. Excess nitrogen and phosphorus from fertilizer can reach watersheds and harm downstream resources of all kinds, including larger water bodies such as the Chesapeake Bay and the Gulf of Mexico. And in some areas, excess nutrients can threaten drinking water sources. The challenges we are announcing today will spark innovations that will help keep fertilizers where they are needed, on corn and other agricultural fields and out of our waterways. The challenges are a request for proposals for two separate prizes, one with a monetary prize at the end and the other with scientific recognition as the prize. Both challenges are an effort to find new ways to maintain or increase crop yields while reducing the impact of fertilizers on the environment. The first challenge, called EEFs, Environmental and Agronomic Challenge, involves Enhanced Efficiency Fertilizer, a method that controls fertilizer release or alters reactions that reduce nutrient losses into the environment. Development of EEFs would be an important addition to conservation practices in this country, and while there is no monetary prize, the winners will receive recognition from EPA, the Department of Agriculture, and other organizations. The second challenge, the Next Gen Fertilizer Innovations Challenge, is a prize meant to generate new inventions or concepts that can lower the environmental risk of agricultural practices while either maintaining or increasing crop yields. The submissions will be judged by experts, and each winner will receive at least $10,000. For these challenges to be viewed as successful, they must show an ability to reduce losses of nitrogen and/or phosphorus into the environment while avoiding unintended consequences. They must maintain or increase farm yields without increasing net farm costs, and they must establish a diverse stakeholder group to help activate market forces and scientific innovation. If these goals are met, then the challenge will have served as a great purpose and the agricultural community will be better for it. Those competing for the EEF award must submit their entries by September 21st, 2020, and for the Next Gen Fertilizer Innovation Challenge, participants must submit entries by October 21st. Winners will be announced in early 2021. So thank you ahead of time for all those participating and good luck. When other nations around the world look for the best in agriculture technology and expertise, they look here to the United States. This is a testament to partnerships like this joint effort to support farmers and ranchers across the country while improving the environment. I look forward to continuing to work with USDA and our partners to ensure that U.S. agriculture remains the best in the world. Thank you.
All right, thank you, Administrator. Next up, I am pleased to introduce the U.S. Department of Agriculture's Secretary, Mr. Sonny Perdue.
Well, thank you, and thank you to my friend, Administrator Andrew Wheeler. This is a great effort to do more with less, which is really the story of American agriculture for almost the last 100 years. And I'm very proud at USDA to join the EPA. Andrew, I'm not sure that America has seen a more collaborative relationship between the Environmental Protection Agency and since its formation in the United States Department of Agriculture in solving problems for our farmers and ranchers across the country while continuing to remain good stewards and improving the environment. So we're delighted today to join you in this effort. Once again, do more with less in that way, which fits right into our ag innovation agenda that we announced earlier this year. I've had the opportunity certainly to travel all across the country and see the very best that American agriculture has to offer. And I don't need to tell you or anyone else that America's farmers and ranchers are some of the most innovative, creative, early adopters of new technology on the planet. And it gives me a great deal of pride to represent them in this effort as well. In February, just like about the time everything locked down, I announced USDA's Agricultural Innovation Agenda at the USDA's Ag Outlook Forum. And we believe it's our job at USDA to tell the great story of American agriculture and highlight the successes and advances we have to feed a growing world, while at the same time challenging our producers and ranchers to do more with less. And that's exactly what we did. One of those examples is how significantly U.S. agriculture has grown over the past 90 years, essentially increasing the production of food and fiber about 400% while using nearly 10% less land. And the key to this success was innovation, certainly, and it'll also be the key to our future success, you know, going forward. With the Ag Innovation Agenda, I committed USDA to stimulate innovation so that American agriculture can achieve the shared goal of increasing U.S. agricultural production by 40% while cutting the environmental footprint of U.S. agriculture in half by 2050. The only way we're going to achieve that is by doing what we're doing here today, and that's developing new innovative technologies that can maximize agricultural outputs while also improving the environment. Working with partners like you at EPA and our private sector partners that are joining us in this collaboration here, as well as producers like Kevin Ross and Iowa Farmers, we're going to reach those goals. And we've done it before. We're going to continue to do it because it's important for America. When we announced this enhanced efficiency of fertilizers were exactly the type of innovation that we had in mind. They improve efficiency, can increase yield, and can match the time when nutrients are needed to be released to the time when the crops need them. They're a great example of how we can harness innovation to continue making agriculture more productive and more environmentally sound at the same time. This competition, as you indicated, Andrew, includes two challenges to seek proposals for new and existing enhanced efficiency fertilizer technologies that maintain or improve crop yields while at the same time reducing environmental impacts. This public-private partnership is the best way that we can all work together to feed a growing world population and achieve our Ag Innovation Agenda goals. And I thank all of you. I thank our Nature Conservancy, I think our Fertilizer Institute, our Development Center, and EPA and the USDA collaboration. We're going to get this done. I'm excited to see the results and all the creativity and innovation that these awards will stimulate. So thank you for allowing us to be a part of this today. And thank all of you for participating. And certainly I look forward when we can be together personally again and get this COVID behind us where we can celebrate these kind of wins together. So thank you all and God bless y'all. Stay safe.
All right. Well, thank you for your enthusiasm and support, Secretary Perdue. So as you've heard, EPA is hosting the Next Generation Fertilizer Challenges in partnership with USDA and also in collaboration with the Fertilizer Institute, the International Fertilizer Development Center, the National Corn Growers Association, and the Nature Conservancy. We've invited each of our collaborators to join us today to offer some remarks. So first off, I'd like to introduce Laura Moody, who is the Vice President of Stewardship and Sustainability at the Fertilizer Institute.
Thank you, Administrator Wheeler and Secretary Perdue, for launching these challenges and highlighting industry innovation to address nutrient losses, which impact both the farmer's bottom line and the environment. We value our engagement with EPA and USDA, and we're so proud to be a sponsor of this effort. The Fertilizer Institute is the voice of the U.S. fertilizer industry, representing policy and stewardship for fertilizer producers, wholesalers, retailers, and those who support them in their business. For more than a decade now, we've worked with our members and stakeholders to advance for our nutrient stewardship based on applying the right nutrient source at the right rate, the right time, and in the right place. We've used education and research to support products, tools, technology, services, and people that increase four-hour practice adoption on the farm. Fertilizers allow for crop production at yields that meet global demand. However, nitrogen and phosphorus applied without consideration for four-hour principles can lead to nutrient losses impacting both water and air quality. Enhanced efficiency fertilizers and other new product technologies and formulations can increase a plant's ability to use fertilizers and reduce nutrient loss. And in a farm's conservation system, they can reduce impacts on the environment while increasing productivity and profitability. TFI members are investing in research and development to meet the demands of future agricultural systems. And we see public and private partnerships such as this one as key to improving the product registration process and farmer access to new technologies that provide key benefits. The two Next Gen Fertilizer Challenges launched today will further stimulate innovation and increase on-farm adoption of effective fertilizer technologies. So thanks USDA, EPA, and our other co-sponsors for collaborating with the Fertilizer Institute. We're glad to be a part of the solution for America's farmers. Thank you.
All right, well, thank you for your hard work and your support, Laura. Next, I'm happy to introduce Upendra Singh, who's the Deputy Director of Headquarters Research at the International Fertilizer Development Center.
Honorable Secretary for Agriculture, Mr. Sonny Perdue, Environmental Protection Agency Administrator, Mr. Andrew Wheeler, colleagues and friends, good morning. IFDC is indeed honored to be a partner in the EPA-USDA Challenges on Enhanced Efficiency Fertilizers and Next Generation Fertilizers. IFDC's vision of healthier soils and plants for food secure and environmentally sustainable world is firmly anchored on improved nutrient use efficiency. So indeed, we are very excited about the EPA-USDA challenges, and we look forward to promoting the next generation of fertilizers. IFDC will also be able to share the lessons we all learned from the challenge with the rest of the world. The challenge will showcase the fact that environment protection, food and nutritional security, and farm profitability can be achieved without compromises and trade-offs, creating a win-win for all. With all our partners and challenge applicants, we will work together and to make the EPA-USDA challenge a success. Thank you very much for inviting IFDC to be a partner in these challenges. Thank you.
All right, excellent. Thank you, Upendra. And now from the National Corn Growers Association, I'm pleased to welcome President Kevin Ross.
Good morning. Thank you for having me here this morning. Appreciate the comments made so far, and certainly wanted to say definitely appreciate Secretary Perdue and Administrator Wheeler for their efforts on this particular program and moving this forward. The National Corn Growers Association is proud to be represented here and participate in this announcement. This is a great opportunity to partner with USDA and EPA in developing new technologies that will help farmers advance their sustainability efforts. Corn farmers are committed to sustainability and have made major improvements in recent years related to fertilizer use and nutrient management. But farming better is a journey, not a destination. We're always looking for ways to make our family businesses successful and do so with an eye toward healthier soil and cleaner water. Major changes in agronomic practices like no-till, cover crops, and the method and timing of fertilizer application are allowing us to continue to improve our environmental footprint. Next Gen can foster increased adoption of these practices, especially with its mission of maintaining yields and not increasing net farm costs. History shows us market-driven initiatives that are non-regulatory and focus on demonstrated effectiveness in the field are the ones to be adopted. The Next Gen Fertilizer Challenge checks all these boxes, so NCGA is very confident that it will be a success. Thank you very much.
All right. Well, Kevin, thank you very much for joining us. And finally, I'm pleased to introduce Carrie Vollmer Sanders, who's the Director of Agricultural Engagement with the North America at the Nature Conservancy.
Thank you very much. And I'm really glad to be here today. Administrator Wheeler and Secretary Perdue, we really appreciate your collaboration and moving this challenge forward. The Nature Conservancy is a private nonprofit whose mission is to conserve the land and waters in which all life depend. And we believe it's this kind of innovation and ingenuity and collaboration through the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenge, which will help conserve more of our natural resources. Innovation is at the core of agriculture, and throughout the past century, advancements in agriculture have enabled farmers to feed a population that has grown from less than 2 billion to more than 7 billion people today, and the demand for food continues to grow. Some of the long-held ag practices have inadvertently degraded our soils or impaired water quality in our rivers and streams, putting at risk the very resources America's farmers rely on. U.S. agriculture has always been on the forefront of invention, and it is clear that the future of ag will continue to require solutions that not only increase food production, but also safeguard our communities, our land, our water, and our air. The way we manage our lands and fertilizer is an important part of that solution. Nitrogen and phosphorus are essential to healthy crop production. And the Nature Conservancy is a strong proponent of the 4R nutrient stewardship framework. We also believe there is great value in exploring innovations in soil health, production, and management of fertilizer, including the enhanced efficiency fertilizers. We're really excited to join EPA, USDA, and the other organizations that are launching the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenge, and look forward to seeing ideas supporting pragmatic solutions and good science for the next generation of innovators destined to help our farmers feed a growing world while also protecting our lands, water, and air.
All right. Well, I want to thank you all for joining us for the announcement of the Next Gen Fertilizer Challenges. We look forward to receiving the innovative proposals for solutions to address the issues of excess nutrients to protect human health and the environment. And now, James, I'll hand it over to you.
Thank you, everyone. For all press on the call, please refer to the call-in information previously sent for a Q&A with Administrator Wheeler and Secretary Perdue. Thank you and have a great day.